This time last year, crowds were continuing to build at an occupation on the grounds of Parliament. The group might only have represented a minority view, but the occupation quickly became a hugely divisive subject. A year on, COVID restrictions have been lifted, and Whena Owen spoke to some of the key figures from the occupation to see how they reflect on the protest.
Look at this, whānau. We're setting up, we're going to pitch up.
You could say the occupation started right here with the first tent up.
We're here to stay.
And that's the voice of this man, Te Pouro Kawakawa, recording his tent pitching on Facebook.
We figured the roads are all blocked, and there's six security guards. If we can get them up, surely these people here have tents and they'll start following suit.
And so they did, covering every patch of Parliament's lawn and then sprawling beyond the gates. Te Pou was there to reclaim ancestral land, he says. He's taken his occupation on the road with other campers, occupying Mahanga Bay in Wellington and now here at Lake Horowhenua. He sees himself as a protector.
A protector of our treaty rights, protector of our national rights, both Pākehā and tangata whenua, even though a lot of people don't see it and understand what it is I'm talking about or what it is I'm doing.
Hey friends! We're going around asking them what their favourite part of the protest is so far. What's yours, babe?
Honestly, everyone is just so full of love.
Hi.
During the occupation, social media influencer Chantal Baker amassed 98,000 followers on Facebook.
No, stop throwing stuff! Stop it!
Okay, let's get out.
Did you think that there wouldn't be that element wouldn't be attracted to the occupation? Do you think you were naive in thinking that people wouldn't do that?
I would just say that I'm definitely a non-violent person and I've never really been around people that have ever kind of resorted to violence in any way, so it's not something that I'm accustomed with. But at the same time, I'm not surprised because at the beginning of the day, I mean, the police came in very forcefully grabbing people.
This is what you wanted, keyboard warriors!
Since that final day when her live stream got over 1 million hits, Baker has had two Facebook pages shut down.
I think there's been a lot of disingenuous contact between Facebook, Dart and NetSafe, and that's resulted in the government being able to choose who gets a voice and who doesn't get a voice.
Her father, Leighton Baker, took on a leadership role at the occupation. A few weeks ago, he popped up on a preferred Prime Minister poll.
And 3.9% want former new Conservative leader Leighton Baker.
I was very surprised, absolutely. I mean, I'm not part of a political party at the moment.
So you're thinking of putting a political party together?
I won't say anymore at this stage, but we do have a plan, so something will come out in the near future, yeah.
Today is the day that the people take back control of New Zealand. We've had enough of the bullshit.
Leighton Baker will be competing with other former Parliament protesters like Outdoors and Freedom Party co-leader Sue Gray.
When you walked into the grounds, what did you find?
Since these days at Parliament, conspiracy theorist Liz Gunn has also announced she's giving politics a crack.
Is there anything else you want to say?
Thank you for all that you're doing, Liz.
Oh.
Thank you for this.
But the mandates are over. There's a new Prime Minister. What drives these influencers? Are they hooked on the attention, the notoriety even?
If I wanted to be notorious, I think I could have picked a platform that everyone found popular, and instead I picked something that was very difficult to do, that influenced my life in absolutely drastic ways.
Following the occupation, Voices for Freedom have attempted to influence politics, standing candidates in local elections with little success. Last week, they told their followers they're working on an exciting secret project. ...253 people were arrested in relation to protest activity in and around Parliament grounds. Most charges were withdrawn, but there are still around 66 active prosecutions. The Independent Police Conduct Authority received 2,000 complaints. Their report is due late next month. On Friday, a small gathering of people who had taken part in the occupation got together at Parliament.
While many Wellingtonians would rather forget the 2022 occupation of Parliament, these people have vowed to make March the 2nd, which was the final day of the occupation, a calendar fixture. And this year, they'll be commemorating it at a camp on the outskirts of Dannevirke.